Hello everyone. Now I would like to explain one experiment in Power System Dynamics lab. In which so far we completed SMIB system, steady state stability analysis, and dynamic stability analysis. Steady state stability analysis have been completed with the help of root locus and body plots. Dynamic stability analysis have been completed with the help of dynamic response or time response of the system with step input. Further, we will study the complete stability analysis of SMLB system by using eigenvalue approach. As well as SMIB system with constant field excitation. First, let me explain the stability analysis of SMIB system. SMIB means single machine infinite bus system. So, incoming generator is connected to the infinite bus. The infinite bus is nothing but so to which many of the generators are connected. So that it forms infinite source for energy. So therefore the frequency and voltage of the infinite bus is always constant irrespective of load variations. As shown in the figure, the generator is connected to the infinite bus. Infinite bus voltage is V and generator voltage is E. The equivalent circuit shows that the generator is taken as classical model of the generator is considered, in which the generator source is E dash at delta and the reactance offered by the generator is XT dash and salient pole machine. If it is cylindrical, it is XS, X dash, XT dash or X dash. The generator voltage is E, so which is connected to the infinite bus through a transmission line of reactance XC. Therefore, the total reactance of the system is shown in the figure 2, that is the equivalent circuit of the system. XT is equal to total reactance is summation of XT dash plus XE, and S is the complex power injected by the generator. P plus JQ equal to E dash IT conjugate. So that is equal to E dash V by XT sin delta plus J E dash into E dash minus V cos delta by XT. Therefore, T is obtained as T is equal to E dash V by XT sin delta and Q is equal to E dash into E dash minus V cos delta by XT. In per unit air gap, torque is equal to the air gap power. Therefore, TE equal to PE, that is equal to E dash V by XT sin delta. Linearizing about the initial operating point, delta is equal to delta naught. So delta TE is expressed as dou TE by dou delta into delta delta. So that is equal to E dash V by XT into cos delta naught into delta delta. The next continuation. The equations of the motion are expressed as P is the d delta by dt. d by dt and P into delta omega are equal to 1 by 2 h into Tm minus Te minus kd into delta omega. So that is the first equation. Second equation is P into delta is equal to omega naught into delta omega r. Therefore, by linearizing equations, and by substituting delta TE, we get next equation P delta omega r is equal to 1 by 2 H into delta TM minus KS into delta delta minus KD into delta omega r, where KS is the synchronizing torque coefficient and KD is the damping torque coefficient. The KS is equal to E dash V by XT cos delta naught. Therefore, the state space equation of x1 dot and x2 dot, therefore x dot is equal to ax plus bu in that form. So x1 equal to delta omega r, x2 equal to delta delta. So x dot is equal to delta omega r dot delta delta dot. So that is equal to a into x plus b into u. So that is equal to minus kd by 2h minus ks by 2h omega naught 0 into delta omega r into delta delta plus 1 by 2h 0 delta tm. Therefore, A is the state matrix is given by minus kd by 2h minus ks by 2h omega naught 0. So by taking eigenvalues of the A, we can obtain the poles of the system, open loop poles of the system. So based on the open loop poles of the system, we can analyze the open loop stability. Here omega naught is the 2 pi f naught. F naught is equal to standard frequency, torque frequency, that is 50 hertz. Therefore omega naught is equal to approximately 314. Ks is equal to, is calculated from the Kundu test book. The data is taken. Ks is equal to 0.757 system. You can verify the Kundur test book for that. H is equal to 3.5. Kd is equal to damping torque coefficient is 0, plus 10 and minus 10. For three different values of the Kd, we can simulate and get the stability analysis of the SMIB system. So let me take SMIB system, single machine infinite bus system example 12.2 from Kundur. So IT is the terminal, that is the load current of the system. Generator is feeding IT is equal to 0.9 minus J 0.3 pu. E dash is equal to 1.123 at 13.92 degrees PU, XT is 0.95 PU, and KS is obtained from E dash V by XT into cos delta naught, that is equal to 0.757 per unit torque by radian. So from which we obtain the state equation, X dot is equal to AX plus BU, from which A is obtained as minus 0.143 kd minus 0.109 314 0 into delta omega r into delta delta plus 0.143 0 into delta tm. So from which characteristic equation of the system is obtained, lambda square plus 2 zeta omega n lambda plus omega n square is equal to 0. So where lambda 1, lambda 2 are the eigenvalues of the system is given by minus zeta omega n plus or minus omega n square root of 1 minus zeta square. So omega d is equal to omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. For three different values of kd, 0, plus 10, minus 10, we'll obtain the lambda 1 and lambda 2 values as well as zeta values as follows are specified in the table. So next one, so let me explain how to calculate the eigenvalues of the system and how to comment on stability based on eigenvalues by using MATLAB programming. So in this slide, I'll explain the program for kd is equal to 0, the very first one, CLC clear all, kd is equal to 0. So we'll obtain the matrix A from kd value. So substitute the kd value in the matrix expression, you will get the matrix A, from which we will get the eig of A, we will get the eigenvalues of the A. Based on eigenvalues, we can understand that eigenvalues are nothing but open loop poles of the system. When all poles are negative, negative real or negative or imaginary part, which may comprising of imaginary part. So when all the eigenvalues are negative values, that means all roots are lying in the left half of the S plane, then the system is said to be stable. If some of the roots are positive, then the system is said to be unstable. So therefore, for kd is equal to 0, so you will get the roots as imaginary, maybe imaginary. So those roots, based on imaginary roots, we can conclude that we can conclude that the system is critically stable or prone to instability. So second program represents that kd is equal to 10 plus 10, so we can get the A value minus 0.143 into kd space minus 0.108 semicolon 314 0. So eigen eig of A, we'll get the eigenvalues of the system. So these eigenvalues might be negative values, then the system is stable. Thirdly, we can get the program for kd is equal to minus 10, where you will get the eigenvalues. Those eigenvalues might be positive, and hence the system is unstable. So those are the eigenvalue programs. Based on eigenvalues, we can also go for eigenvector calculations, and further we can comment on system stability based on now let me explain the symlink model of the SMIB system with constant field delta EFD. Here, as shown in the figure, 1 by 2 HS plus KD is the generator model, and 0.01 is the delta TM mechanical input, and K3 by 1 plus ST3 is the field circuit dynamics of the synchronous machine. KD is the damping torque, K1 is the synchronizing torque, and omega naught by S is taken as, omega naught is the gain, and 1 by S taken as integrator. You can have the scope at scope 1 for delta omega and scope 2 for delta delta. So the K4 is taken from delta delta to voltage loop. So delta EFD is the 0 step input is given here, 0 step input, and the remaining values, SMIB system values, are taken as K1 is equal to 0.7643, K2 0.8649, K3 0.323, K4 1.4187, T3 is equal to 2.365, omega naught 314, KD 0, plus 10, minus 10, H is equal to 3.5. For all these specified values, let us simulate the given system and get the responses of delta omega. And also, I explained in the class, K4 may be negative in some cases. When you have the negative K4, so let us take the K4 some negative value and simulate the same, you will get the different result. So let us understand the effect of negative K4 value on system stability. In the subsequent chapters, we will see the Phillips-Heffron model and the effect of excitation system and then power system stabilizer. This is for power system dynamics lab. Now let me explain facts lab. So far we have completed TCR, thyristor controlled reactor, single phase and three phase, and their THD analysis by using FFT analysis. Some people have done that sequential switching of TCR to mitigate the harmonics injected by the TCR, and then we have simulated SC TCR type SVC without sequential switching and with sequential switching both, and we have concluded that with sequential switching the THD of the SC TCR type SVC have been reduced tremendously. In continuation to that, TSC TCR type SVC is considered to reduce the harmonics injected as well as to have the control over your reactive power injection. So TSC TCR type SVC is comprised of different blocks. So let us consider three TSCs. So in the figure I have shown two TSCs. Let us consider two TSCs and one TCR. The TCR size should be 1.5 times of each TSC. Suppose if you consider the 11 kV system, in the 11 kV system 10 kVAR is the TSC rating, each TSC rating 10 kVAR, 10 kVAR, 20 kVAR. So you can consider the TCR rating as 15 kVAR. Once you got the 15 kVAR, so TCR rating is 15 kVAR, TSC rating is 10 kVAR each one. So total TSC 1 10 kVAR, TSC 2 10 kVAR, 20 kVAR, and TCR 15 kVAR. So you will get total rating as net rating 15 kVAR capacitive. If you consider all the three blocks, if you switch off one of the TSC, TSC 2 is switched off, then TSC 1 is 10 MVAR, TCR is 15 MVAR, together will have 5 MVAR or KVAR, whatever you can take, anyone in per unit you can take MVAR, KVAR. Actual rating, but per unit it is same. In per unit, suppose TSC rating is 1 PU, TCR rating is 1.5 PU. So therefore 10 KVAR, 15 KVAR, together we have 5 KVAR if it is KVA. If it is MVAR, 5 MVAr. Anything is okay. 5 kVAr inductive. Lagging var you can inject. So when both the TSCs are off, only one TCR is on, then you will change the TCR rating from minimum value to its maximum rating. That is, maximum rating is 15 kVAr. So like that you can control the TSC TCR type, SVC. So in which we have to observe the voltage and current waveforms and FFT analysis of TSC TCR type. Initially let us take two TSCs are on and one TCR is on. You can change alpha 20 degrees, 40 degrees, 60 degrees for three alpha readings. Let us obtain the current and voltages as well as THD values of the current and voltages by using FFT analysis, what you did in previous experiments. The same thing is valid here also. You can do in similar way, and you can switch off one of the TSCs and repeat the same. You will get the responses with single TCR. Okay, so repeat the same problem with TCR sequential switching. That is, you can break TCR into four parts. Three parts are switched on or off, like operating as TSRs, and one is controlled with alpha, one is controlled as a TCR. In that case, let us observe the THD content of the system. So we can observe that the THD content with sequential switched TSC TCR type SVC is further decreased compared to SC TCR type SVC. So based on that you can conclude. So let us simulate in the Simlink with two TSCs and one TCR. Two TSCs and one TCR is separated into four parts with sequential switching. Among four, three are operated as TSR and one is operated as TCR, and see the THD content. So we'll try to simulate and get back me with your feedback. If you don't get, you can interact with me through WhatsApp. Thank you.